Welcome to the first of several examples of how to factor an expression by factoring out the greatest common factor. It's important to remember the first step in any factoring problem is to factor out the greatest common factor. So to factor 5x plus 25, since there aren't any variable factors in common, we want to find the greatest whole number that would divide evenly into 5x and 25. If we're not able to determine the greatest common factor by inspection, it's often helpful to write our terms in prime factored form. 5x means 5 times x, and since 5 is a prime number, this is the prime factored form of 5x. And 25 is equal to 5 times 5. Again, both of these factors are prime. Once they're written in prime factored form, we can actually see their common factors. Notice how both of these terms share a common factor of 5 and no other factors. Therefore, our greatest common factor is 5. So we're going to factor out the 5, leaving us with a factor of x plus 5. So showing this work is helpful because the common factors give us the greatest common factor, and then whatever is not common gives us the remaining factor. And of course, we can always check this by distributing. Notice how we have 5x plus 25. For our second example, we have 16x minus 24, so we want to find the greatest common factor between 16x and 24. And again, since there are no variable factors in common, we're looking for the largest whole number that would divide evenly into 16x and 24. And if we can determine the greatest common factor just by thinking about it, that's great. But if not, it's going to be helpful to write out the prime factorization of 16 and 24. So let's go ahead and do that. 16 is equal to 4 times 4. Each factor of 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So the prime factorization of 16 would be 4 factors of 2. Of course, we also have a factor of x. So we have 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times x. And now we'll find the prime factorization of 24. Well, 24 is 4 times 6. Again, 4 is 2 times 2, and 6 is 2 times 3. So now we have 3 factors of 2 and a factor of 3. So minus 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. Now that's in prime factored form, we'll identify all of the common factors between these two terms. Notice how both contain 3 factors of 2. And since 2 times 2 times 2 is equal to 8, 8 is our greatest common factor, which we'll factor out of this expression. So we'll have 8 times the factor is not in common, which would be 2x minus 3. And again, if we want, we can distribute to check this. We would have 16x minus 24. Okay, I hope you found these two examples helpful. We'll be looking at several more examples in the next few videos.